Hi, it's Mike Chen. So this is rock music, literally. These chime-like sounds come from a geological phenomenon known as ringing rocks. Physically, they look no different from regular rocks, but it's not until you slightly strike them with a hammer that the rocks reveal their sonic secret. Also known as sonorous rocks, these audio boulders can be found in various locations inside the 128-acre Ringing Rocks Park in southeastern Pennsylvania, including Stony Garden in Buck County, Devil's Race Course in Franklin, and Pottstown in Montgomery. The most famous among visitors is located in Upper Black Eddy near the Delaware River. Framed by a lush forest and a majestic waterfall, the site features a vast 8-acre field of ringing rocks with some stacked as high as 10 feet. It was here that Dr. J.J. Ott performed for the Buck Wampum Historical Society in June of 1890 for what is probably the first rock concert in history. According to Natural History Magazine, Ott played several musical selections while accompanied by a brass band. The performance highlighted the natural musicality of the rocks, which he assembled into an octave scale. Since Ott's performance, this site has attracted other musicians looking to compose one-of-a-kind soundscapes using the ringing rocks. Recording artists like Philadelphia-based Thomas Rex Beverly also made the visit to the park to take audio recordings of the rocks. He observed that the changes in environments also changed the sound of the rocks, which means what the rocks sound like in the summer isn't the same as they do in winter when layers of snow surround the rocks, which also create significant changes in the pitch. But a more interesting discovery is that while only 30% of the rocks ring, they generally ring in the tone of B flat. And if you're wondering why that in particular is interesting, well, that's because B flat is what a supermassive black hole sounds like. Back in 2003, NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory detected sound waves coming from a black hole 250 million light years away from Earth. Turns out it's been humming a B flat that's 57 octaves below middle C for close to 2.5 billion years. It's out of this world tidbits like this, so to speak, that fueled the wild urban legends surrounding the origins and the mechanisms of the ringing rocks. So in 1965, geologist Richard Foss performed numerous lab tests on the rocks to find out if there's a connection between the physical makeup of the rocks and their ability to create sound. What Foss found was an explanation to one of the most widely claimed myths about the ringing rocks. Unlike the stories that the rocks don't lose their ability to make sound when taken out of the boulder field, they still produce a series of low frequency sounds which remain inaudible to the human ears until it's layered with similar low frequency sounds coming from other ringing rocks. But while he was able to debunk one myth, Foss still wasn't able to identify the specific physical evidence that would explain, well, why do these rocks ring? So instead of getting the answers, he actually raised more questions like, if the rocks were all made from diabase, a volcanic basalt that's high in iron and aluminum content, then why do only a few of the rocks ring? Why aren't the rocks in nearby areas of the field ring as well? And since diabase is the same substance as that of the Earth's crust, does that mean that the Earth is like a giant bell? And how did the boulders even get there in the first place? One theory suggests that when the supercontinent Pangaea shifted some 300 years ago, it caused mountains to erode and the sediments to settle in nearby valleys. Magma worked its way up to the surface, depositing large amounts of diabase into the soil in the process. Scientists believe that the boulders were created from what they call the freeze-thaw cycle, where the water that's permeated, the hardened mixture of magma and sediments goes into a loop of freezing and melting, which eventually split the giant rock formation into individual boulders. That would make for a very satisfying explanation into the mystery of the ringing rocks. If only, one, there were volcanoes in Pennsylvania, and two, well, if it actually cracked this mystery. Also, because even extensive scientific studies couldn't provide a definitive explanation on why the rocks ring, speculations of the more peculiar variety abound. Some think the ringing rocks are surrounded by a bizarre magnetic field, rendering compasses unusable. It is also rumored to be an ancient ceremonial site used by Native Americans who used the rocks for their rituals. Others believe that the boulders are pieces of meteorite that crashed on Earth, and that radiation is why there's no vegetation or animals that settle in the boulder field. And of course, we cannot talk about the inexplicable without chalking it up to aliens. Take Stonehenge. The ancient monument has never been a stranger to green spacemen and conspiracy theorists, even more so now that ringing rocks were discovered on the site. Researchers from the Royal College of Art, under their Landscape and Perception Project, discovered that that the blue stones were the inner circle of Stonehenge shared the same musical ability as that of the boulders in Ringing Rocks. Evidence showed that almost all of the rocks have scuff marks on places where it might have been struck, proving that the rocks were specifically chosen for their ability to make ringing sounds. And by some strange coincidence, and it just so happened that the stones were sourced from Priscilla Hills, where a village named Minklachog, which translates to bell or ringing stones, is located. And records show that the townspeople used blue stones as church bells until the 1800s. To add to the mystery, recent archaeological findings reveal that Stonehenge is part of a complex network of 17 other previously unknown ancient structures, including nearby Durrington Walls and Avebury. Using sophisticated equipment like a ground-penetrating radar and a 3D laser scanner, the pioneering digital mapping project covered an area of 12 square kilometers worth the size of 1,250 football fields. What they discovered was a labyrinth of burial grounds, ritual sites, and processional routes and prehistoric trenches, all seemingly converging towards the direction of Stonehenge as its center. Following various cultural studies, what links Stonehenge's blue stones and the boulder field in Pennsylvania is that the ringing rocks they're made of are considered sacred across different ancient civilizations. They were thought to contain powerful spirits that may have been used in religious ceremonial practices as a way to speak to the gods. But no matter how similar the role of ringing rocks around the world are, in the context of history and culture, there's still not one physical characteristic that exists among all of them that could explain why they ring. And so the mystery continues. Who knows, maybe it really is aliens, and all the worlds in the universe are just one massive rocking intergalactic mixtape. But for now, I'm calling ancient giant musical instruments. That's all I got. What's your guess? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you later.